Alright, greetings ladies and gentlemen. You all know me as Mike VOG94, and here's a little heads up, I've been drinking. And this is gonna be my little attempt to play a Super Nintendo classic, Home Improvement. So I did a little test playthrough of the first level just a minute ago. And now I think it's time. Oh, hi, Mr. Tim Allen. Your pixelated greatness. Toolman is prime. Anyway, I don't think you can hear anything about this. This song here sounds like the beginning to a Knuckles theme from Sonic Adventure. Sounds a little bit like it. I expect Tim Allen to start rapping any minute now.
Here I come, rougher than the rest of them, messing them, tougher than the other.
You see, unlike Sonic, Tim Allen doesn't chuckle. But anyway, let's get all this boring cutscene crap. Now I've officially practiced this a little bit. So, I've gotten a little used to the warp controls and the really dipshitty designed levels. So, I'm gonna show you the location of all these crates. And I'm gonna blow through it like it's a piece of cake. You know, my little test playthrough took a lot out of me. No lie. So, as you can see, there's a lot of slopes, and level design kind of makes you think you want to make this a Sonic the Hedgehog style game, but, you know, there's not the same physics and momentum as Sonic, because obviously it's Tim Allen, and who the hell's expecting Tim Allen to reach the speeds of Sonic the Hedgehog after all? But that's what the designers seem to have been going for in this wonky looking level design. So, and to be fair, I mean, you can make some nice leaps and bounds with certain jumps to get to these little secret areas where you collect bolts and find the rest of the crates, but at the same time, everything's so confusing. All these enemies and obstacles just kind of blend into the environment, so you end up taking a little chip damage just by running into the ship that the game expects you to see. But realistically, you can't avoid being hit. Like look at that enemy placement right there, and those spikes. How exactly are you supposed to avoid that realistically? Oh, god damn. And these enemies respawn like crazy, too. It's almost like the second after you hit them, they come back on screen. That's not a good challenge. So anyway, on my test playthrough, I game over twice. And I was drunk for that, too, by the way. This is all just kind of spur of the moment. To do tonight is not really doing it at all. But yeah, I game on twice just trying to find the location of the crates and move around this forsaken level. And as you can see, that hard hat gave me a little bit of invincibility. And it doesn't last very long. And by the time you break through these godforsaken rocks, chances are you're not going to be able to blow through enemies at all. So anyway, these little nuts you see here kind of act like the rings in the classic Sonic games, where they're basically your hit points, and if you get hit without carrying them, then you automatically die. See, look how many hits this stupid raptor takes. And I'm pretty sure I've killed him before, and he's just respawned right on top of me. Like, That's not fair design at all. Be a bitch if I just time over in this. Oh, by the way, I unlocked the chainsaw, which kind of acts like the master sword in the original Zelda games. It just shoots a little shockwave of light. And, oh, I still have it, even though I got hit. That's not what happened in the test playthrough. In the test playthrough, it was one hit and I lost the chainsaw. But yeah, these enemies just take so much money. Area stage, only in the dark, and I'm still wielding the Master Chainsaw, the bane of dinosaurs' existence. Like, why would it take like 4 hits to get rid of that stupid ass raptor? By the way, this jackhammer pogo stick kind of move is really important if you wanna spam that if you wanna get through these. Does the little shockwave attack just stop there? Why wouldn't it go a little bit longer so you have enough range to reach Rodler or take it out from a distance?
yellow. Oh no, I'm in the top pants. With a flamethrower? Why are there dissolving platforms there? Come on, grapple up there. Grapple up there. Kill him! Get up there! JonTron video, so I know definitely not to leap from there. You'll die. There's nothing but a pit over there. Which is stupid that they make like a little walkway for you to leap across. Thank you. Damn it! Stupid targets jump your junk too. Now, come on, get out of here. What? Jump out on top? Improvement standards is counts as a speed run. Stage lights too. Yeah, that doesn't really do anything. No! Does it take me back to level one? Why the fuck are you running back to the second, you idiot? Ask our great audience what they think. Okay, audience, let's hear from you. Well, yeah, obviously. Start me back at level 2. I'm back at level 1! Oh my god! Well, let's see if I can do it again. Yeah.
lost chainsaw, so I'm back to the dinky little nail gun from before. By the way, there's different, like, moves, that, you can use by using the, well, I'm using a Rock Candy 360 controller with a SNES 9X emulator. So, basically, it would be the X button that you would see on the Super Nintendo. So, basically, suddenly awesome. Holy shit, you can do the bandit bounce from classic Sonic. I thought I had to tell Tim Allen not to die. enemy placement was very excellent.
The dog,
damn it. I made a pun and got killed. Okay, please. I should save it afterwards.
Oh my god!
Yeah, fuck that. This is going on long enough. I should know if I can run the industry. Fuck you, Jim Allen. Fuck you, Home and Prue. Good night.